الفيديو ده كان مليان فيه وديس اللي كان سيوز ديس ريال ديس بروبرتي تو فايند اوت ذا لابلاس ترانسفورم اوف ديس سو ديس بيكم ليت اس دينوت ذا لابلاس ترانسفورم اوف اكس تي باي اكس اوف اس سو اكس اوف اس بيكمز ديس بارت فروم هير ا ايكوال تو 2 ان ديس كيس ا از 2 سو ديس بيكمز 1 upon s plus 2 and this ROC should be real of s greater than minus 2 and for this part we get 1 upon s plus 3 and this ROC should be real of s greater than minus 3. Now the Laplace transform of xt will converge to this and this provided both of them converges simultaneously. So there should be a common solution of this. What is the requirement? On real axis of S plane, this is S plane and this is the real axis. So at real axis, its requirement is real of S has to be greater than minus 2. And this requirement is the real of X to be greater than minus 2. So what is the common solution? If real of s is greater than minus 2, then this satisfies this one, it will be greater than minus 3 also. So the ROC for this will be greatest of the two, largest of the two. So real of s has to be greater than minus 2. Now we have done two parts. We have find out what is the Laplace transform expression and what is associated ROC. Now we have to find out what are these poles and zeros. For pole and zero, let us simplify this. This into this, s plus 2 into s plus 3, and this plus this, that means 2s plus 5. Now, zeros of x of s, finite zero of x of s is given by zeros of the numerator. So this requires say zeros. Zero of x is given by twice of s plus 5 equal to 0. That means s must be minus 5 by 2. And the poles are given by zeros of the denominator. That means s plus 2 into s plus 3 equal to 0. This becomes s equal to minus 2 and minus 3. So we have got two finite poles which are situated at s equal to minus 2 and s equal to minus 3 and s equal to minus 5 by 2. They are real poles. So we have to plot this. S equal to minus 2 is a real number. So at minus 2, we have got a pole. A pole is marked by the sign of cross. At s equal to minus 3, we have got another pole, which is again marked by cross. And at s equal to minus 5 by 2, we have got a 0. So minus 5 by 2, somewhere here, we have got a 0 here. So this is the pole zero plot. This is S plane. Pole zero plot. And from pole zero plot, we can find this signal or Laplace transform terms again. let us try to do the part B of 9.21. Part B, which says xt is a signal given by e raised to power minus 4t ut, then e raised to power minus 5t sine 5t ut. We have to find out its Laplace transform. We can attempt finding the Laplace transform directly from the definition of Laplace transform, but that will complicate the matter. So you are advised to use Laplace transform table for this. In Laplace transform table, you can view that e raised to power at ut Laplace transform is given by 1 upon s plus a, RC being real of s greater than minus a. And again in the table of Laplace transform, e raised to minus a t, we have just done it up. Sine omega naught t ut, the Laplace transform of this, we have just determined is omega naught upon s plus a whole square omega naught square. Yeah. Now if I use these two rails, then getting its Laplace transform becomes very easy. If I put a equal to 5, 4, then I get this part. Laplace transform of this part from here. So the a is equal to 4. So x of s now becomes 1 upon s plus 4, provided this ROC is real of s greater than minus 4. And now, if I take a as 5 and omega naught also as 5, a as 5 and omega naught also as 5, then I get this term from here. So now it's Laplace transform, omega naught is 5. So 5 upon s plus 5 whole square, and then 5 square, that means 25. This is its what you call Laplace transform. This is s plus 5. And here ROC must be real of s greater than minus 4, and for this part RC is real of s greater than 0. So the associated ROC becomes real of s greater than 0. Largest of these two is real of s greater than 0. So we have done two parts. First, the Laplace transform of this and the associated ROC. Let us look at the pole zero plot. For pole zero plot, we have to simplify this. X of s, this becomes s plus 4, and this becomes s plus 5 square plus 25. I am just multiplying these two. Then this comes over here, s plus 5 square plus 25, and then 5 into this. 5s plus 1. Now let us simplify this. This becomes s square plus 10s plus 25 plus 25 then 5s plus 20 divided by s plus 4 s plus 5 square plus, let me write this as 5 square. Now this can be simplified as s square. This is 10s plus 5s, that means 15s, and this is 25 plus 25, 15 plus 10, 20 plus 20, that becomes 70. S plus 4, S plus 5 square plus 5. Now let's try to find out this poles and zeros. Let's find out the poles of X of S. Given by the zeros of denominator polynomial, that means s plus 4 into s plus 5 whole square plus 5 whole square. So we get two solutions, s and this equal to 0 and s equal to minus 4. And then this is going to be 0. S plus 5 whole square plus 5 square equal to 0. Now this becomes S plus 5 whole square minus 5 square. This minus 1 can be written as J square. So 5 square J square. We have 5 J square. Now S plus 5 becomes plus minus 5j. That means s becomes minus 5 plus minus 5j. So we have got three poles. One this and two number of poles here. So in this case, you can plot the pole. At s equal to minus 4, there is a pole. Say this is minus 4. This is the real axis. This is plane. At s equal to minus 4, we have got a pole. And then at s equal to minus 5 and plus 5j. That means somewhere here and at a distance say 5. Let's mark somewhere 5 here. So here is a pole. This pole is minus 5, 5j in terms of coordinates. And then we have got a pole at minus 5, minus 5j. It is a complex conjugate of two. So at the distance minus 5, minus 5j in terms of coordinates. coordinates. And zeros you can find by factorizing this. You can factorize this by quadratic. S is equal to say minus b plus minus b square, that means 225 15 square minus 4ac, that means 280 by twice. So s becomes this You can write here 0 is of x of s, or given by this, and now you can find that s is equal to minus 15 by 2 plus minus, this difference becomes 5 6 with a minus sign by 2. So we can write s is equal to minus 15 by 2 plus minus j square 65. This negative I have taken j square by 2. So this is minus 15 by 2. If I take square root of j square, it becomes plus minus j root 65 by 2. So it has got a pair of complex 0, and that you can graph here. This is simply by 2. You can graph the two zeros, one zero will be somewhere here, whose coordinate will be minus 15 by 2, j root 65 by 2, and the other zero will be here. Sorry. Since this is negative, the zeros will also lie in the left half of this plane. Minus 15 by 2, that means 7.5 somewhere. Minus 7.5, suppose it is here. Then, 1 0 will be somewhere here. You can write this coordinate as minus 15 by 2. Then, j 65 by 2. Coordinate. And the other 0 will be exactly a mirror image of this. Minus 15 by 2 minus j root 65 by 2. So these are the whole zero plot. Whole zero plot. Fine. Now let's see to part C of 9.21. Here, x t given is e raised power y t to the minus t. Then, e raised power 3 t to the minus t. Let's take here, and we know its Laplace transform is 1 upon s plus a. Then, what is the Laplace transform of this? If you reverse in time, that t means gets replaced by minus t. Then, what is Laplace transform? Let's see, we have seen that it is 1 upon s minus a. This should be that. But let us try to do this directly. So Laplace transform of this from defining equation will be s power 2 u of minus t plus e raised power 3 t u of minus t e raised power minus s t d t. Then, if we apply the definition of u of minus t, then this becomes minus infinity to 0 e raised power 2 t plus e raised power e raised power minus st dt. This becomes minus infinity to 0 e raised power minus s minus 2t, then e raised power minus s minus 3t infinity. If I integrate these two, I get e raised to power minus s minus 2t upon minus s minus 2. Then e raised to power minus s minus 3t, and this becomes minus s minus 3. And which is the limits are to be related minus infinity to 0. So in that case, if I evaluate the limit, I'll get this delta is 1 upon s minus 2 plus 1 upon s minus 3 with the restriction that real of s, RC will be real of s less than minus 2. And if I simplify this, I'll get s minus 2, s minus 3, and this becomes twice s minus 5. In this case, getting poles and zeros, determining poles and zeros is a very simple task. At s equal to 2, we have got a pole, at s equal to 3, we have got a pole, and a 0 at 5 by 2. Now you don't need that. Then, so straightforward to get this 0 and pole, 0 at s equal to 5 by 2. Somewhere here, we have got a 0 which is 5 by 2. And poles are at s equal to 2 and at s equal to 3. There are two finite poles and one finite 0. This is pole 0 representation in S plane. Yes, plane.